Hello, my dear kids. Today we are going to do another mathematics lesson. Let's start the lesson now. Unit 3, addition of numbers. So kids, in mathematics we have four mathematical operations which we are using to solve the sums: multiplication, division, addition and subtraction. Out of those four, today we are going to discuss addition. Here you can see the addition sign or else the plus sign. And whenever you are adding two or more numbers together, the value is increasing. And we use addition to find totals. Let's see today's world. What are we learning today? Today we are going to add numbers with one carryover and addition with two carryovers. Addition of four digit numbers with more than two carryovers. And we are also going to learn how to write statements. Now kids, we are going to add numbers with one carryover. Here you can see there are two numbers, two 4-digit numbers. So here you have four place values, units, tens, hundreds and thousands. So we have to start addition from the units column. And always make sure to place the plus sign in your sum, because that is how you can identify the mathematical operation which you have to use in the given sum. So here this is addition. So kids, what does it mean with one carryover? Now let's say the sum. Let's start addition from the unit column. So 8 plus 6 is 14. 14 is a 2-digit number. You have 1 and 4, 2 digits are there. So one carrying over means when you have a 2-digit number, you keep the unit column digit in the unit place, while the tens column digit, you take it over to the tens place. Because units you can keep under the unit column, that is its own place value. But tens you have to take to the tens column. So in 14 you have 2 digits, 4 is in units and 1 is in tens. So let's keep 4 in the units place as it is, and we'll take 1 over to the tens column because that is in the tens place. So let's add then 5 plus 3 plus 1 which you have taken from the units. Adding together, the answer is 9. You can keep 9 as it is. Then go to the hundreds. 2 plus 1 is 3. Thousands, 3 plus 2 is 5. So the final answer is 5,394. Let's see this question. Here we are going to add with two carryovers. So that means in two places you have to carry that over to the next place value. Let's learn it later. Now see kids, in this question it comes in another different way. Here you have given a small picture. So this is a school. In this school there are 4,273 boys and 3,457 girls. So you all have to find the total number of students in this school. For that you need to add these two numbers, number of boys and number of girls together. Since these are 4-digit numbers, again we have four place values, units, tens, hundreds and thousands. Let's write these two numbers one below the other. 4,273, 3,457, and make sure to place the plus sign. Okay, let's start addition from the units column. 7 plus 3, 10. So put 0. Tens 0, you keep 0 in the units place and take 1 over to the tens place. Then add 7 plus 5 plus 1. You get 13. Once again, the digit in the unit place keep under the tens place, and then the other digit you take to the next place value, which means to the hundreds. And again you add, you have 2 plus 4 plus 1, which you have taken from the tens place. Now you have 730 hundreds, tens and units. Now add the thousands column. That is 4 plus 3 is 7. Now can you understand that, kids? Now units column you can keep, the maximum value is 9. Tens column maximum value is 99. Hundreds column 999. Now see the answer which you have taken to the first three columns, hundreds, tens and units. That is 730, which is smaller than 999. So then let's move to the thousands. 4 plus 3 is 7. So the entire, the final answer is 7730. So now hope you understand it. When you have the places, you need to add the places correctly and keep the maximum value there while taking the rest of the digits to the other columns. Now kids, we are going to add 4-digit numbers with more than 2 carryovers. Here I have expanded the number so you can clearly understand what I mentioned earlier, the carryovers. See the numbers given: 2138, 1986. Once again you have 4-digit numbers. So you need tens, hundreds and thousands are there as the place values. So once you expand the numbers, so how to expand the numbers? The given digit you have to multiply by its own place value. 2 into 1000, 2000, plus 1 into 100, 100, 3 into tens, 30, 8 into ones, 8. So likewise, I expanded the numbers. Now let's try to add the expanded numbers. 8 plus 6, that is 14. So written 4 in the units column. There you can't keep 2 digits. So keep it there and take it to the other side. Now what happened? You have 30 plus 80. Now can you understand? When it is expanded, you can see 3 is 30, 8 is 80. Now, once you add 0, 0, 0, then 8 plus 3, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 plus the other one you have taken, now you have 12. So can you keep 120 under the tens column? No, 99 is the maximum. So we'll take that one which is actually in the hundreds column to the hundred place. You are taking 100 to the hundred place. See, which is mentioned in the green color, that is 100. So 100 plus 900, 1000. Then you have another 100. So that means 1000 and 1100 is there. So how can you do the other one which is in the thousands column? You have to take to the thousands column. So 2000 plus 1000 plus the 1000 which you have taken from the 1000 column, now you have 4000. So once the numbers are expanded, it is clear to understand how these carryovers happen in the sum. Now see the normal way you are doing. 8 plus 6, you put 4, carry 1 over to the tens column. 8 plus 3 and added 1, so 2 kept there and taken 1 to hundreds. 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 1, 11, keep 1 there and take 2 to the other one to the other. So 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1 is 4. 4124 is the final answer. Let's learn how to write statements. So this is the first time you are writing statements in your grade 5. So kids, statement questions are much different from the other questions. Here you have word problems, means the question is given in little elaborated form, written in words, in sentences. So you have to read it and understand it. So how many times you need to read a statement question? At least you have to read it three times, thrice. First you just read it. Second time, while reading, you underline the important words, the given numbers in the question. Third reading is to finalize your sum, understand it, and try to pick out the statements. Now, when you are writing statements, you need to focus on the given question. You don't want to find words from the different ways. The given words, the question is having some words. So you have to take the same words which is appearing in the question. So let's try to understand this question. Let's read the question. A vehicle importer has imported 1,918 cars, 1,293 vans, and 2,421 lorries. During the first 3 months of the year, find the total number of vehicles imported. Now class, let's see what are the differences and what are the information, data given in this sum. The first thing is, the earlier sums we added only two numbers. But here you can see you have three numbers. So what is it about? These are about some vehicles which has been imported by some vehicle importer. So here you have cars, 1,918 cars and 1,293 vans and 2,421 lorries. Now can you see, when I'm reading my second reading, I underline the numbers given in the sum. Cars, how many cars? Vans, how many vans? And lorries, how many? And can you see the word in red? So this is the most important word in this question. The word giving you the correct way to do the sum, the correct mathematical operation. Find the total number of vehicles imported. So total is the key word in this sum, which carries the mathematical operation, which is addition. So class, now try to write the statements. See the first one, number of cars imported. See, these words are there in the question itself. I didn't take any other questions from the outside. All these are given in the question. Number of cars imported, 1,918. Number of vans imported, 1,293. Number of lorries imported, 2,421. See the last statement, I added another little word. Total number of vehicles imported. Then you have to add all the digits in the given numbers, three digits in one row, and get the answer. 8 plus 3 plus 1. 9 plus 1 plus 2. So normal addition, but you have 3 numbers to add. And can you see, I placed the addition sign also, the plus sign, which is really really important. Let's see this question now. So this question is in another different way. It is different from the earlier one. Here you have a table. So you have to read the table, interpret the table, and pick out the answers. Now let's read the question. The cash collection of a vegetable vendor at a market during 3 days is given below. What is the total collection during the 3 days? Now in this question kids, there's nothing much to underline in the question. Yes, you should underline the word total collection and 3 days. You are going to concentrate on the 3 days. And you are going to add all the 3 days to get the total collection. All the other information given in the table. So the table is having two columns, days and collection. Monday, 2,315 rupees. Here you are having units, rupees. Tuesday, 3,265 rupees. Wednesday, 5,174 rupees. So you can easily add these numbers, write in one below the other and get the final answer. And if won't, you can try writing the statements also. You can write, how can you write it? The money collection on Monday, the money collection on Tuesday, or else the cash collection on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. So you have to write three statements and the final statement, the total collection of the 3 days. So then add and get the answer. So can you try this answer? So kids, today we learned how to add numbers. So you can do the relevant exercises posted in your student note. We'll be meeting again with another new lesson. Till then, stay safe. Thank you.